Good morning. I'm sorry I can't join you today because I truly appreciate the invitation from the Great Lakes Commission and wish my schedule in Congress would allow me to join you in person. But nevertheless, I'm honored by the opportunity to spend a few moments talking about the incredible national treasure of the Great Lakes. As many of you know, I've been a longtime representative of Great Lakes communities across western New York. And over the years, I've represented 100 miles of Lake Ontario coastline, stretching from Niagara Falls to the Port of Rochester. No matter where I've traveled, every constituent I speak with shares my passion for protecting the Great Lakes for future generations, a passion that I know all of you share as well. For so many people, the Great Lakes define the place they call home. And for millions of Americans along the shores of Lake Huron, Ontario, Michigan, Erie, and Superior, weekends are spent boating, fishing, and relaxing with family and friends. Meanwhile, the work week is defined by the shipping and exporting that supports millions of jobs and puts food on the tables of American families. Despite the unique and irreplaceable value of the Great Lakes, the future from the lakes is far from assured. From the record low water levels to toxic areas of concern, and the threat of Asian carp and other invasive species, there are tremendous challenges that must be addressed if we are to protect the lakes for future generations. As we all know, perhaps the greatest danger to the future of the Great Lakes is the growing threat of Asian carp. The U.S. spends billions of dollars every year trying to contain and eradicate invasive species. The Aquatic Nuisance Species Task Force estimates that recent introductions of 15 invasive species to the United States could cost taxpayers as much as $134 billion by 2050. And as the carp have moved northward to the doorstep of Lake Michigan, I've made it a priority in Congress to ensure that the federal government does everything it can do to prevent their spread into the lakes. Last April, I was pleased to join my Republican colleague from Michigan, Congressman Dave Camp, and introduced the Stop Invasive Species Act. The legislation was included in the final surface transportation agreement last summer, and it requires the Army Corps of Engineers to expedite the Glimmer study and finally present Congress with a plan to permanently restore the natural divide between the lakes and the Mississippi River. There are so many lessons we can learn from the introduction of the Asian carp in the United States. We have to strengthen our laws so the federal government has the tools it needs to identify and to prevent the next invasive species before it ever reaches our shores. Specifically, Congress must update the Lacey Act, a 111-year-old law that is ineffective and certainly out of date. Under the Lacey Act, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service faces hurdle after hurdle when taking action against a species like Asian carp. In fact, under the Lacey Act, it takes the agency an average of 4 years to officially list a species as injurious, a designation that allows a strong response to stop the spread of the species before it's too late. And 4 years is far too slow a response for an ecological threat that is increasing by the day. This type of designation should be made much sooner so that stronger action can be taken before a species invades our ecosystem, instead of after the fact. And to solve this growing problem, earlier today, I introduced the Invasive Fish and Wildlife Prevention Act of 2013. This legislation would strengthen the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's ability to designate animals as injurious and to take strong protective action against the next harmful invasive species. Specifically, the bill directs the Fish and Wildlife Service to establish a new pre-import risk screening system to identify the greatest invasive threats around the globe. And doing so would allow our federal regulators to stop those species from coming into our country. It also provides the Fish and Wildlife Service with the emergency authority to temporarily prevent the importation of potentially harmful species until further studies can be conducted and a final determination can be made as to their potential threat. This would all be done with public input in a transparent and scientific manner. And together, these changes would speed up our ability to respond to the threat of invasive species and identify and stop threats before they damage Americans' waterways any further. In order to see such priorities turned into law, it is vital that every member of Congress know just how important the Great Lakes are to our economy, to our country, and to our planet. We are fortunate that when it comes to protecting the Great Lakes, there is a bipartisan team of legislators that fight hard for the intelligent federal policies to protect the lakes for generations to come. And I am so proud to be co-chair of this bipartisan group called the Congressional Great Lakes Task Force, and to work with colleagues from across the political spectrum to implement the policies today. In these tough economic times, it's clear that updating laws like the Lacey Act not only improves the health of the lakes, but saves the American taxpayer money. With updated laws and stronger tools to fight invasive species like Asian carp, we can act more quickly and efficiently to fight the species and avoid billions of dollars in additional costs that we will incur if they are allowed to invade the ecosystems like the Great Lakes. It is my hope that my colleagues on Task Force and I can convince our fellow members of Congress that the growing threats to the lakes and the cost of inaction require us to take action today. But in order to succeed, we will need the continued support of people like you. We need you to continue to call and write every member of Congress and build support among friends and family and neighbors for the strong federal laws that will protect our Great Lakes. You've done so much already, and I'm confident that together, with your continued activism and support, we will succeed in updating our laws and protecting the Great Lakes for generations to come. From the western shores of Lake Superior to the beaches of western New York, the future of our American economy and the way of life for American people is indelibly tied to the health of our Great Lakes. So thank you for being here today, for continuing to fight for the future of the lakes and the well-being of the communities that dot the shores and the millions of Americans who rely upon the Great Lakes every single day. Thank you.